British expeditions to protect their Indian trade routes led to campaigns against Ras Al Khaimah and other harbors along the coast, including the Persian Gulf Campaign of 1809 and the more successful campaign of 1819. The following year, Britain and a number of local rulers signed a maritime truce, giving rise to the term Trucial States, which came to define the status of the coastal emirates. A further treaty was signed in 1843 and, in 1853, the Perpetual Maritime Truce was agreed. To this was added the Exclusive Agreements, signed in 1892, which made the Trucial States a British protectorate. Under the 1892 treaty, the Trucial Sheikhs agreed not to dispose of any territory except to the British and not to enter into relationships with any foreign government other than the British without their consent. In return, the British promised to protect the Trucial coast from all aggression by sea and to help in case of land attack. The exclusive agreement was signed by the rulers of Abu Dhabi, Dubai, Sharjah, Ajman, Ras Al Khaimah and Al Qawain between 6 and 8 March 1892. It was subsequently ratified by the Governor-General of India and the British government in London. Citation needed. British maritime policing meant that pearling fleets could operate in relative security. However, the British prohibition of the slave trade meant an important source of income was lost to some sheikhs and merchants. In 1869, the Qubaisat tribe settled at Kar al-Udeid and tried to enlist the support of the Ottomans, whose flag was occasionally seen flying there. Kar al-Udeid was claimed by Abu Dhabi at that time, a claim supported by the British. In 1906, the British political resident, Percy Cox, confirmed in writing to the ruler of Abu Dhabi, Zayed bin Khalifa al-Nahyan, Zayed the Great, that Kar al-Udeid belonged to his sheikdom. British era and discovery of oil. During the 19th and early 20th centuries, the pearling industry thrived, providing both income and employment to the people of the Persian Gulf. The First World War had a severe impact on the industry, but it was the economic depression of the late 1920s and early 1930s, coupled with the invention of the cultured pearl, that wiped out the trade. The remnants of the trade eventually faded away shortly after the Second World War,